Hey, you guys, stick around to see how I did this baby doll look. Hey, you guys, it's Steffi. How are y'all doing? I hope everyone is having a great day. Today, I'm gonna do a baby doll eye look. I'm going to try. This is by request. So thank you for the suggestion. So the first thing I'm gonna do is basically the thing about baby doll eyes is you want your eyes to be as big and wide as, not really so wide, but big eyes. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into like a medium brown color, and I'm just going to go on the top crease and I'm going to wing it out. I probably should have put a little more on, but I'm trying to build it up. I don't want to put too much. So I'm just taking it on the very upper crease and I'm winging it out. And I'm gonna blend a little bit below and a little bit above just so it's not so harsh. And you don't wanna put too much on the inner corner. Oh, also, I learned a lot of these tips. I wanna give her credit by Angela Bright. I watched her video on how to do it, so I'm gonna be using some of her tips, but I'm also gonna be kind of putting my own, hopefully Asian flair on it. I'm gonna take a smaller blending brush and I'm gonna go into a dark brown and I'm gonna put that right on what is going to be my crease. So I'm putting it right under the medium brown. And again, I want to build this up. I don't wanna start out with too much. And I'm also gonna flare that out. And I'm trying to, I always go like this when I do my eyeshadow. I'm trying to relax my eyes as I do it because I want it to look, you know, when you look normal at the camera or whatever, you want it, that's how you want it to look. So I hope that made some sense. Next, I'm gonna go in with a flat fluffy brush and I'm gonna, there's a white and a cream color. So I don't wanna do white, but I don't wanna do too dark. So I'm gonna mix these two together. And I'm just gonna go on the lid with that. And I'm gonna also flare that out because you want your eyes to be as wide as possible. I'm not doing it as good as Angela did, but that's why I'm kind of doing my own thing. She did it a lot better. So check out her video. And I'm gonna add a little bit of white, just white, into the inner corner to brighten that up. Okay, now let me find my white eyeliner. We're gonna use white eyeliner and then we're gonna do the exact same thing on the bottom. So here it is. White eyeliner, I don't think looks really good on me. Like, I'm trying to get used to it. I've done a couple of looks with it and I'm really trying to get used to it, but it's just so, like, it's not what I'm used to. So that just goes on the waterline. And then a little bit past, just a little bit further out, like where you would do your wing. Just a little bit further out. Because again, you want your eyes as wide as possible. I always think that white eyeliner kind of makes my eyes look bloodshot. I don't have any Lumify right now. I usually use Lumify. That stuff is awesome. So I'm gonna take the fluffy brush and I'm gonna go back in with the medium brown. And I'm just gonna put that all over the bottom. And then I'm gonna go with a flat brush, just a flat, fluffy, like it's more flat than fluffy, so a flat brush. And I'm gonna take the dark and I'm just gonna go in right underneath where the white eyeliner is. The purpose of this is to just make it high contrast so that the white sticks out better. And again, with this, you're gonna go just a little bit past like where you would do a wing. Oh, I forgot what color I was. There we go. Just a little tiny bit past. Thank you, Angela, for these tips. I really, really appreciate it. I think it's coming out looking pretty good. Over the white with the white eyeliner one more time, just to make sure it was very, very white. So now I'm gonna take a black eyeliner pencil and I'm just gonna do underneath, because I'm not gonna be using any eyeliner on top. So I just wanna make sure that you don't see the skin when I put my lashes on. Ooh, my eyes are watering. Don't water. Okay. Now let me go find some. I got some manga. They're called manga lashes. They're like an Asian, they're like a cosplay kind of lashes. So that's what I'm going to use on the top. And then I'm going to use some relatively natural lashes on the bottom. So I'll be right back. Got my little thing filled up with glue. And I'm going to take these natural, very natural bottom lashes. I've used these before, but I think they'll be perfect for today's look. And I'm just gonna dip the eyelash, if I can see what I'm doing, into the glue. And then when I put them on, I'm gonna put them on way out here on the bottom, instead of like right up against my lash line. On the outside, I'm gonna put them way on the bottom. That's just on the outside though. And then I'm gonna go in like normal. Or I think I just got glue on my tweezers. We all know how much of a mess that makes. Oh, I got a lot of glue on that one. Come on now. It's sometimes hard to put these little dainty eyelashes on top of your own eyelashes. They don't want to stick, especially if you don't have a good hold of it like I do right now, or I don't right now. So I'm gonna try to get a better hold of it and get the glue off of my tweezers. Dip it back in the glue. There we go. Now, if you can see, it's making the eyes look wider because they're not right up against the lash line. I like to do my bottom lashes first, just because it's easier to see what I'm doing when I don't have top lashes on. This is not going well. Every time I film doing bottom lashes, something goes wrong, but when I'm not filming it, it goes fine. There's a big spot of glue in there. I hope that dries okay. Sometimes you just get too much glue, but it'll dry. clear, hopefully. Let me get some of that off. It's hard to tell, like, when you're dipping these dainty little lashes into glue, it's hard to, sometimes hard to tell how much glue you're actually getting. Oh, I'm sorry, you can't see. I'm sorry. All right, you know what? I'm just gonna finish these up and I'll be right back. I have these lashes. They're called manga, I think, but they're used for cosplay. They are very spiky and doll-like. So I'm gonna try these and see how they look. I'm doing this without eyeliner, so it's not gonna be so easy. I had to get it way down on the lash line so that you can't, y'all. That's exactly what I was going for. I can't believe that worked out. Get that right down on the lash line, almost putting glue in my eyes. But, oh, that looks awesome. Okay, I'm gonna do the other one. Hopefully this next one, I'm gonna bend it a little bit. They're very stiff. I don't even think I need to put eyelashes. My God, y'all. Mascara on these. I think they're good the way they are. In case y'all are wondering what I'm doing, that's my little trick for making eyelash glue get tacky faster, is I blow dry it. Ooh, y'all, these are perfect. You guys. Okay, so now I'm gonna very carefully put some mascara on my bottom lashes just so they stand out a little bit more. Very careful not to smudge. This is one thing I'm not great at, is doing bottom mascara, but I think that went pretty well. So I hope the glue is dried enough for me to be doing this. Yes. Yes, y'all. This makes me happy. I didn't think this was gonna look good, especially on me. I just don't like these kind of looks on me, but this is coming out, y'all. It's coming out. All right, I'm gonna go do my face makeup and I'll be right back for lipstick. So I think a red lip is in order, but I'm not gonna do it like I normally do it. I'm gonna try to do it in like a doll-like shape. So I'm gonna go very thin on the top line. I'm not gonna go to the end. I'm trying to stop myself. And I'm gonna try to do like a heart shape. I don't know if this is really coming out to be a heart shape, but I'm not going to the end. I'm going to the, like, before the end. This is why I'm not a makeup artist. I don't even know how to describe what I'm doing. Okay, and now for the lipstick. That's cute. I've never done it like this before. This is cute. This I messed up a little bit up here. There we go. Okay, now I'm just going to go in with the white eyeliner one more time. I just really want it to stand out. Very nice. This worked out well. I did not think this was going to work out well. My hair didn't come out the way it did the other day. It was really, really cute. It had like spring things all over the place, but I just couldn't get it to do it today. But this is my baby doll look. I hope you guys enjoy it. I want to thank Angela Bright for giving me tips and tricks in your video. I loved your video, and in your video helped me out a lot. So I really appreciate it. I don't know if you're ever going to see this, but thank you, thank you, thank you. And thank you guys for sticking around and watching my videos. I really appreciate all your support, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time. You guys, oh my God, I'm so embarrassed. I'm so sorry. It wasn't Angela Bright. It was Alexandra Anell, and I'm gonna tag her in this video. I am so sorry. I apologize so much. I got the name wrong. Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed. So I will tag her in this video, and hopefully she'll see it. Okay, bye.